हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर गिरीश रायसिंघानी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, एसपीसी गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज, अजमेर. इन आर लास्ट लेक्चर वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इकोलॉजी एंड वी डिस्कस अबाउट एन इंट्रोडक्शन टू प्लांट इकोलॉजी. दैट वॉज पार्ट वन. एंड नाउ इन पार्ट टू वी आर टेकिंग द इकोलॉजी एंड इट्स डिविजन्स. इकोलॉजी मे बी डिवाइडेड इंटू ऑट इकोलॉजी एंड सिन इकोलॉजी. First, horticulture. It is the study of individual species in relation to its environment. It includes geographical distribution, morphology, life cycles, and the impact of ecological factors on its life cycle at different stages. Environment affects several aspects of the vegetative and reproductive growth of the plants. Horticulture is also called species ecology. An applied branch of horticulture is agronomy, which deals with the various aspects of crop plants. Then comes the syndicology. It is the study of plant communities, which include populations of several species, their structure, organizations, development, and causes of distribution in relation to environment. It is termed as biosynology and biosociology by many Europeans. To understand the ecology of plant communities, the ecological life cycles of at least the most important plant species of a community must first be studied. Thus, hort ecology forms the basis for syndicology as well. Branches of ecology. For a better understanding of various aspects and details of ecology and its application to mankind, it has been categorized further into the following sub-branches. These include habitat ecology. It deals with the habitat as a central theme and plants and animals as a mere inhabitants. It includes forest ecology, grassland ecology, freshwater ecology, marine ecology, desert ecology, farmland ecology, etc. Then paleoecology. It is concerned with the organisms and the relation with geological environments of the past. Cytoecology. It deals with the cytological details of the populations of species in relation to different environmental conditions in which they live. Conservation ecology or resource ecology. It is concerned with the proper management of biotic resources and also resources like minerals, water, and soil necessary for our well-being. Then comes ecosystem ecology. It deals with the structure and functioning of ecological systems in relation to space and time, and also analyzes the various ecosystem components and their interactions. Ecological energetics and production ecology deals with the mechanisms and quantity of energy conservation and the flow of energy through organisms and food chains and food webs. Energy production possesses productivity of various ecosystems, assimilation, at various trophic levels in relation to time and space also come under the scope of these branches. Then comes the phytogeography. It deals with the geographical distribution of various kind of vegetation on the earth. Then is zoogeography. Deals with the geographical range and distribution of various animals on our past, on our planet. Then is radiation ecology. It deals with the impacts of various radioactive substances on abiotic environment as well as on the living components of the ecosystems. Then is gene ecology. It studies about the genetic impacts on organisms, example mutation due to various environmental factors, example impacts of UV rays at cellular level of an organism, radiation hazards on organisms, etc. Then is the applied ecology. It deals with the conservation and management of various environmental components from which humans derive manifold benefits. Example, forest conservation and management, cropland management, wildlife management, soil management, water resource management, etc. Then is the scope of ecology. Modern ecology is concerned with the functional interdependencies between living organisms and their environment. Taylor, 1936, in an attempt to define ecology, has very rightly pointed out the scope of ecology by stating that ecology is the science of all the relations of all organisms to all their environments. Ecology has played an important role in several fields and sciences related to welfare of humans and other living creatures. For example, to an agricultural knowledge about this crop and its relations with the environment is a must for obtaining maximum yield for crop improvement, crop rotation, weed control, etc. Ecology comes to his aid all this while. A forester relies on necessary information about the ecology of a deforested wasteland in order to inhabilitate it with suitable varieties of plants, trees and fauna. The concepts of agroforestry, social forestry, sand dune stabilization, reclamation of wasteland and other afforestation methods enormously rely on necessary inputs from ecologists. The livestock industry is greatly benefited when an ecologist through his knowledge converts a depleted grassland into a productive one for the grazing population of the area. Ecology forms an integral part of several measures taken in fields of solid waste management, prevention of soil erosion, control of desertification, control of droughts and floods. In recent times, ecology has played a vital role in combating issues of greenhouse gases, climate change, ozone layer depletion, smog, etc., and holds a promising status for the mankind's bright future. Hence, ecology has affected our lives at every level, from our foods, clothing, consumer goods, our health, the air we breathe, the water we drink, our croplands, our cities, and hence finds an integration not only with biological sciences but to the physical and social sciences as well, directly or indirectly. Now we can also study the ecology and its relation to other fields also. And ecology, as we know, understands studies about the living organisms and their abiotic environment in continuous interaction with each other. The holistic concept of environment underlines the fact that its biotic and abiotic components cannot be dealt in isolation if we need to understand life of this biosphere. So it is very necessary that we have to study the ecology and its relationship with other fields, like how plants help maintain the balance of carbon dioxide and oxygen in nature. It is also related to plant physiology. Then it's also related with plant anatomy also. We can also study the concept of environment, that there are many approaches, the holistic approach, and the idea of environmental complex, and what are the factorial approach, some conclusions. So, and then many laws of which are related to ecology, then the levels of organizations. We can also study the population, its community. Then we also to study ecology in India, what are studies are going on. So this all comes into the introduction of plant ecology.